4029's Commitment 2012 debate with candidates of Fayetteville's mayoral race. It's a race of two mayors. We're joined by current Mayor Lionel Jordan, who won the seat 4 years ago, against his current challenger, Dan Coody. The candidates will respond to questions tonight. You'll have 1 minute, of course, for the opening statement. Let's begin with you, Mr. Coody.
Yes. I'd like to say thanks for letting us come out here and do this evening. It's always good to be able to address the public and to be able to, my favorite thing is to take questions and have a conversation back and forth. But when we were in office 4 years ago, we were doing all kinds of wonderful things with all the community input that we had. We built the trail system, the library, with a lot of public input and help, the senior center, rebuilt College Avenue, the square, the botanical garden, rebuilt a lot of infrastructure, did all kinds of wonderful things. The sustainability movement started in Fayetteville. But in the last 4 years, basically what we've seen, and there have been some good things that have happened. I don't want to discount the good things that Mr. Jordan and the city council have done in town. But primarily it's boiled down to the parking situation on Dixon Street and the back-end parking on Block Street. And there have been some other minor things that have happened, but those are the two big things that people recognize in Fayetteville. And I think that we need to be back on a trajectory that's more progressive and innovative and entrepreneurial at the same time.
Okay, Mr. Jordan, you have 1 minute.
Yes, I want to thank everybody for letting us into their homes tonight. I want to thank 4029 for us sharing our vision with the people tonight. There's three things that we've done very well under this administration. First, we properly managed the taxpayers' money. And we're, for the first time since I've been an elected official, bringing a balanced budget to the city council. We've created over 1,800 jobs in a recession in the last 2 years. Another thing we've done, we've protected our environment. We have, for the first time, we have a streamside protection ordinance. We'll protect our streams, first one in the state of Arkansas. We have created a green-collar workers training center that's called a center of excellence, so that's very exciting for us. And the last thing we've done very well is that we've been inclusive in our government. We have 5 town hall meetings a year and have for the last 4 years. One of those town hall meetings at the University of Arkansas campus. So we have been inclusive, we have protected the environment, and we build the economic base of the city, and we properly manage taxpayers' money. Thank you.
Okay, Mr. Jordan, you've addressed some of the things we wanted to start out with, but our first question is for you. The last 4 years, what do you think you've done? What would people know is number one or number two accomplishments of the mayor the last 4 years, and should it entitle you to another 4 years?
Well, the thing that we've done is establish partnerships. And we have great partnerships with the Chamber of Commerce, University of Arkansas, and the federal public school system. We have properly managed the taxpayers' money. We have a balanced budget now. We've created jobs. We look forward to the future of this city. But we believe, and there's two types of governments you can have. You can have a consumer-based government that says, what's in it for me? What do I get out of it? Or you can have a partnership-based government that says, we're all part owners of this city. How do we move it forward? Once again, we're going to be looking at water transportation. We're going to be looking at more trail systems. We're going to be looking at properly managing the taxpayers' money without raising taxes.
Now, Mr. Coody, in what the mayor is saying, do you think he's implying that maybe the money wasn't used properly before, or what would you do?
Oh, I think that's a clear implication, and I tell you what, one of the differences between Lionel and me is about this issue of budgeting. Because right now, when you earn money, that's your money to do with as you please. You can invest it, you can blow it, you can go to Vegas. But when we pay taxpayers' money, we pay taxes into the city. That's still the taxpayers' money. And to take that money and extract it from the economy in Fayetteville and to stuff it into the bank, and we shrink the police department, shrink paving, shrink the trails program, and the government doesn't basically provide those goods and services that the taxpayers are paying for and say we're saving money and just stuffing your money in low interest bearing account, I don't find that good governance. You have a cushion in there to where you can really provide all the goods and services you need and still have a nice cushion for those hard times, but to continually put money in the bank, especially when there's more coming in now than ever before, but see our services fall, I don't think that's a good way of doing the public's business.
Mayor Jordan, do you have a response to what the Mayor Coody was saying?
Well, I can tell you, when I came into office, the expenses of this city was $35,800,000 in our general fund, and our revenue stream was $33,500,000. We had to make serious cuts in the city. Now, we had $9 million left in the reserves, but the first year that I was in office, we had to come up with $2 million. So we found that in cuts, we had a couple of choices. When you're in that kind of situation, you can raise taxes on the people, or you properly manage the taxpayers' money, which we cut expenses. And we cut $2 million the first year, we cut another $1.5 million, we cut $3.5 million out of the budget. And we have done that, and then we've been able to add and put a little bit of cushion in reserve. If it had went like it was going, the first year we would use $2 million at least out of the reserves, and it was 22 months of falling revenue. Then the second year we would have got right down to the $5.7 million, and we had to step back and start to manage the money properly.
Well, Mr.
Cootie?
Yes, sir, but I mean, it was a tough time when you left office as far as the budget, correct?
Sure, but we had so much money in the bank at that time because we managed, my administration managed the money very, very well. And we left a nice reserve of $9 million plus a $4 million emergency fund in the budget as well. So there was a lot of cushion there to be able to do some good and to be able to respond accordingly to the rainy day. The emergency fund and that the cushion that we had below the $9 million, well below the $9 million, that's exactly what that was for. So one of the things that Mr. Jordan has been very adamant about in this election is all the debt that he inherited, and this plays into that. And the problem is, in this form of government, the city council accumulates debt by law, or the public does, but not the mayor. The mayor cannot assume or take on any debt. So to say that debt was accumulated because of me or any mayor is just disingenuous when Mr. Jordan on the council and the public basically said we want to make these investments, and we did make these investments, which have been good for town. But to say we should have done that then, but we shouldn't have done it now is Which is it?
Okay.
Let's do look at that debt for a moment. When Mr. Cootie took office, the debt was $31 million in the city of Fayetteville. When I took office, it was $144.6 million. Now, $60 million of that was a wastewater treatment plant overrun that the taxpayers, we had to go back to the taxpayers and get them basically to say, well, this thing is an overrun. We had a partially built wastewater treatment plant. So we had to go back to them and ask them to cover that $60 million. Now, part of that debt was a $60 million because nobody was really watching that project, and it got out of hand. And after 4 years, there was a $60 million overhead had to cover. So that's part of the debt. When we look at the police department budget cuts, what I don't think Mr. Cootie realizes that $978,000 of this $1.3 million in cuts of the police budget was animal services that I simply moved to another department. So that left us about $300,000-$400,000 that we cut by changing the overtime. And then we also cut back on vehicle expenses. So those are two of those things that I'd like to counter with.